Many of rugby's greats have reunited today to send off former All Blacks captain and coach Sir Fred Allen. The funeral at Eden Park was a chance for some of Sir Fred's former players to say a last farewell. We caught up with some of them after the formalities.
Fred's boys, back together. Kirkpatrick, Meads, Lahore and Nathan. What a lineup.
Do you see yourself as Fred's boys?
Oh, yeah, even though we were scared of them.
you know, great teams are built on respect, and we respected Fred, but we also respected our fellow players.
Brian Lahore captained the team in 12 of the 14 tests Sir Fred was in charge of. Today, Sir Brian was a pallbearer with his brothers in arms.
What has this meant to you?
Oh, it's probably the biggest honour I've had since I became an All Black.
How apt that the giants of the game carried out a man many consider a godfather of rugby.
It's the greatest honour one can have and for such a great man.
Yeah, it was a special honour and a humbling honour to be one of the pallbearers and carry him out. It was outstanding.
With a bit of cheek thrown in from that bloke Meads.
What was going through your mind as you were carrying him out?
Well, just goodbye, Fred. You're heavier than I thought you were. And I hope we don't have to go too far.
A day when the greats of the past got together with the modern-day mentor and other Auckland and All Black stalwarts.
Puttle, Thorn.
But to those stars of the 1960s, Sir Fred will always be the coach they revere.
Taken by Kirkpatrick.
I'm sure that if Fred had a coach right through my playing days, I'm sure it would have been a better All Black than I was.
Would he encourage you today to have a couple of handles later on?
I'm sure he'd be upset if I didn't.
The hard taskmaster would have beamed with that trademark glint in the eye at one last team effort from his boys.
Cheers, Fred. Can we stop for a home?